misapprehension, suspicion, oblivion and deception. And it facilitates universal distribution, and it facilitates also proper distribution, deeper distribution and effective distribution. That is known as jnana. Second thing is tyaga, sacrifice, in which we gain by losing things and by seeing people gaining lot of things, but even though we lose, we gain by our loss. So that type of eudaimonic experience which we gain by losing things for the welfare of others is sacrifice. That mentality we can develop only in India, and Indian knowledge source is the only vital source available for that. Third thing is yoga, to feel oneness with God, with creations, with the creatures. Whole universal brotherhood and communal brotherhood, global family, global village, universal brotherhood, oneness with God, everything is there, yoga. That is there in our greatest language of our philosophical tongue. But there are some problems. The second thing is, even though these values are available, they are crude and unprocessed. We cannot handle it. They are crude and unprocessed. Then the next step is, you know that there are a lot of cool drinks like Rasna and other things, there are a lot of energy drinks. They know that, they must have mentioned the label itself. Mix it with cool water or hot water or with milk or any other cool drinks or any other beverages. It must be given there. In all the things, labelation, they must have given that. With any beverage, hot or cold, it must be there. Likewise, we must process this knowledge and give it, mix it in three forms. One is education, second is entertainment, third is exercise. So somebody must give spiritual education. It must be either a silent mixture in the already existing syllabus or as a supportive syllabus. The second thing is entertainment, spiritual entertainment. I used to call it as spritainment. Like educational entertainment, they have framed it as edutainment. So it is spritainment. Then the third thing is by exercise. So whatever the exercise that you do, whatever the entertainment you prefer, and whatever the education you are challenged with, so it must be a processed way of the spiritual values of jnana, tyaga and yoga. That must be done. And there is a problem. Why Westerners are succeeding and these Indian people, they are not succeeding? Certainly, there must be a minus point for our failure, and there must be a plus point with them for their success. We cannot deny everything like that blindly. Even though we are having invisible sources, like Vaikasvata Swayambhuva, Atri Vishnu Harita Yagyavalgya Aushana Paiti Nasi, Angira Yama Apastamba Vaishambayana Ranayaniya Paila Sumandu Jaimani Katyayana Vrihaspati Varasara Vashita Shakti Shanka Likita Pulastya Kanva Taksha. Innumerable religions are there, and we are having lineages with them. But there is no connectivity allowed. So for all invisible people, the binding force, the physical force which creates the effect is connectivity. For all the existing visible forces, integrity. The Westerners, they are having phenomenal integrity. They are having composite integrity in success. Out of either curiosity, out of either fancy, out of either craze, whatever it may be, they are well binded. They will see whether that is true or not. And they are very much vehement in their experimentation, analysis and hypothesis. They are ready to spend their time, they are ready to spend their effort and economy for it. So, in spite of having invisible sources in abundance, we have no connectivity. In spite of having mortal limited visible sources, they have integrity. Now, we have to create a binding spirit, either in the form of a power, or in the form of a person, or in the form of a group of persons who should renew the license of our relative connection and linkage with the invisible, uncountable supporting factors, by means of which we can once again assume the global leadership, and we can lead the whole world, not with any independence or with the idea of getting into the process of enslaving the society. It is embracing the society and enslaving the society. We Indian people are not like that. Let me hope that things will be initiated very soon, and so many things in depth will be discussed in the forthcoming sessions. Narayana.
Yes, energizes, mesmerizes, elevated us, ennobled us, empowered us to such a high level. Please hold on, you should not fly. All movements in the world for the last 10,000 years have started small. Whether it's a spiritual movement of Sai Baba or Amaranandamayi, or a Marxist movement, communist movement of Mao Zedong, started three people: Edgar Snow, Jack Weldon, and merciful. All great movements, Shankaracharya's movement, if you like, everything started small. The first thing which I want to say to all of you, after listening to Swamiji, who mesmerized us, to elevate, give us more energy coming from unknown sources, is to say that though it may take 100 years, we have to be happy with what we can do. A lady teacher went to the Wagha Wagha border, and whenever with the children which she was teaching, primary school children, and the moment the English Indian flag went up, she made the children sing Jinda Uncha Rehe Hamara Bana. Every month she was doing it. And therefore the commandant said, "Madam, why are you doing this? Why are you doing this?" So she said, "That's all what I can do for my country. Every month I come with a 1,000 rupees salary which I have, spend 100 rupees to bring the children here, hoping that one of these 40 children whom I bring every month will produce one person who will rescue this country from power humiliation, harassment, humbling and defrauding and so on. Therefore, whatever we do is more than adequate." I must also say that Buddha was the first man to say, "Don't kill an animal." He was the first man to say, "Oh, Mahavir." Yet all Buddhists are non-degrees. And they made a clever way, as Swamiji was saying. One bhikshu was sitting and saying, "Buddha Charanam Gacchami." One crow was there. Crow said, "Ah." One meat piece came down from his mouth. Came here. He took it to Buddha. "Oh Lord, can I eat it?" He said, "Are you hungry, fellow?" "Yes." "Can you eat it?" "I can try." "Did you kill it?" "No." "Go ahead." That is how Buddhists became non-vegetarians. By clever fraud, which they did that. Therefore, one point number one, that this movement started with Swamiji. He's a chief patron, I want you to know that. It's not written there. Swamiji is the chief patron of the India Century Movement. As far as I'm concerned, everywhere I meet Ambani, he has promised help. This morning I spent 3 hours with Vasant.